Hi, everybody. It's Will with Revelry Motorcycles in sunny Sydney, Australia. We're back with another episode of our all things performance related for the Royal Enfield 650 Twin. We got a really great response to our exhaust video, and we really appreciate the comments and feedbacks. It really feels good and makes it feel like it's worthwhile to do this. So this week we're back with air filtration systems. Let's get into it. All right, so let's have a look at the air filtration system. There's a lot more going on here than meets the eye. Not only, so you've got an air filter box, which obviously contains an air filter covered by an air filter cover, but also attached to that air filter box, a number of other things are going on. You've got an idle air controller that's pulling clean air out of the air filter box. You've got an engine breather attached to the air filter box, and you also got a secondary air injection system consisting of a solenoid that's bolted to the air filter box and a couple of reed valves that are bolted to the front of the engine. Back here, we've got an intake air temperature sensor also bolted into the airbox. Now, all of those things are on the clean air side of the air cleaner. So there is a lot more happening than just filtering air for the combustion chamber. So what does a filtration system do? What's its main purpose and function? Well, certainly it is to filter the air for combustion, to run the engine. There are a number of other things happening as well. So let's talk through how that all works. The combustion chamber filtration happens when the piston goes down with the intake valve open. It creates negative pressure in the combustion chamber. Ambient air from outside is pushed through the air filter and the throttle body, where it's mixed with fuel from the fuel injector and brought into the combustion chamber to be burned. So that clean air going into the combustion chamber is probably the primary function of the air filtration system. But there are a number of other things going on. That idle air controller also draws all its air off the clean side of the air filter, and that's what the engine's running on when it's at idle. Basically, nearly all the air going in at idle is coming through that idle air controller. The breather system is also very critical, and it's got to be on the clean side of the air filter, because when those pistons move down, up and down, not only are they creating high and low pressures in the combustion chamber, but they're moving air, quite a bit of volume of air, around in the crankcases. Sometimes that air is positive, sometimes it's negative. So it both breathes and vents. So in the case where it's venting, you want it on the clean air side so that you don't draw dirt into your engine. And when it's breathing, you want it on the filtered side because you don't want oil spraying out all over the place, because there's always a little bit of oil mist left in that breather. So quite a bit of stuff going on there. The secondary air injection is also on the filtered side, because it's pulling filtered air into the exhaust to help burn the unburned hydrocarbons in the exhaust system as an emission step. So as I said, a whole lot more going on than it looks like. So when you make changes, now if you're just changing a stock air filter, you don't have to think about a lot of that. But if you're going to be doing something like building a race bike where you're taking the whole air filter box out, then it makes a lot of difference. The other thing that's worth mentioning, it's not directly connected to the air filtration system, but it's certainly an integral part of the induction system, and that's the charcoal canister, evaporative emissions control canister down here, which is connected to the fuel tank and houses the hydrocarbons that come off the fuel in the tank when the bike's not running, and allows those to be pulled through this valve that's controlled by the ECU into the engine to purge the hydrocarbons out of this and run them through the engine so that they don't escape out into the atmosphere. Okay, so let's talk about our high performance options. Everybody knows high flow air filters are better, right? Well, basically that's true, but why, right? Well, the bottom line is, when you've got that low pressure area and air being forced through the filter into the combustion chamber, the less restriction, the better. The less restriction you have in front of that air that's going into the combustion chamber, the more air you can get in. And volumetric efficiency is all about getting more air into the engine. So anything you can do to get more air in gives you more to burn. You can make more power. And then, of course, you need a good exhaust to get that out. But the whole idea is less restrictive air filters absolutely allow you to get more air into the engine. Now, there are a number of standard replacement air filters. The stock air filter looks like this, right? And these guys just sit in there, and they are covered with this cover, right? So, oops, there's my intake air temperature sensor. couple of things about this filter. They are, from a performance perspective, they are pretty restrictive. They are also a paper filter, so when it gets dirty, it's time to throw it away and replace it. It's another advantage of most of these performance filters are washable. This is an S&S. Filters are available from S&S, DNA, K&N, probably others at this moment. But they're really straightforward to change. There's only three screws. You're just under this side cover, three screws out of this cover. You can put on the cover eliminators. They certainly help the engine breathe better. That's a set installed on the bike there. Really easy to do. You can put a high flow filter back in with the original cover, but it's fairly restrictive compared to just having a cover eliminator and letting it breathe. All right, next we're going to have a look at what's required if you want to remove that air filter box. Now, if you're building a real live race bike or a really radical custom, you probably don't want that big air filter box in there if you're trying to make it cute. It is a little more involved than you might think. We've got these really nice BMC pod filters that go right on the stock throttle bodies. There aren't a lot of pod filters out there that actually fit. These are the only really high quality ones that we've found so far, because there's not a lot of frame rail clearance right here. So they've got to be little small pod filters like this. But when you replace those pod filters, you've got to deal with all those other systems that are attached to the original equipment filter box. You've got this engine breather, and that's got to be filtered. This intake air or ILAIR controller intake has to also be filtered. So we use these little K&N filters to attach those two and filter them to the outside. Now, in this demonstrator that I've got here, this hose isn't really long enough. You need to run this filter up and attach it to the frame. But what's important to point out is that this filter has to be fitted in this orientation. If you turn this filter somewhere and hang it down, then it's going to collect oil, because in this breather system from the engine, there's always a little oil air or a little oil in that air mist coming out of the breather system. So if you hang that filter down, it will just collect oil over time and begin to drip. It's also pulling air into this idle air controller, and the engine's running off this when it's at idle, so it absolutely has to be filtered. So you need to tee that breather and the idle air controller together to a little filter and be sure the filter is pointed up. The other thing you have to think about if you're going to get rid of that whole box is that whole secondary air system. Now you're doing away with the solenoid and the secondary air system. If you're still running all the stock electronics and the stock EFI system, you will have to leave the secondary air controller solenoid plugged in, or build a resistor eliminator plug for it, because if you just unplug it and walk away, it will throw error codes in the ECU. So if you leave it plugged in, you've still got to get rid of the reed valves or the system on the front of the cylinder head. Now that looks like this in its original equipment. There are two reed valves in, and that hose comes into this fitting that looks like this to feed that air into the exhaust ports. We make a little eliminator, a Revelry eliminator, that is just a polished alloy piece that you use the original O-rings. You just take two bolts out, take one side of this off, take the O-rings off the old one, put it on this, stick it back in, two bolts in, much cleaner, and your whole secondary air system is eliminated. Okay, so what can I expect from a free-flowing air cleaner? Well, we know for a fact that a free-flowing air cleaner and a cover eliminator can make a big difference. We don't have any dyno sheets on just an air cleaner, but we know that an air cleaner combined with a set of S&S mufflers can give you 3% horsepower and up to 6% torque without a tuner or anything else. That's a difference that you can absolutely feel. A high-flow air cleaner is one of those prerequisites right along with exhaust pipes. As we said last week, you start with an exhaust, add an air filter. These are things that will carry you right on through your whole project. A high-flow air filter in the stock air filter box is quite capable of running an 865 up to big horsepower. You don't need a setup like this to make horsepower. You need a setup like this if you're looking to reduce complexity or if you're just trying to make it cute. But the stock air box with a high-flow air filter is quite capable of making big horsepower. So next week we're going to talk about camshafts, and that's because we've got our mate Tom's bike here that we've just done a cam in. And we're gonna next week we'll show you the dyno sheets on this. It has headers, S&S race only mufflers, an S&S air cleaner, an S&S cam, and a Powertronic tuner. And it's been to the dyno and had some pretty good numbers. So we'll be sharing those with you next week. If you want to be sure not to miss that, subscribe, click the bell, share with your friends, leave a comment, and remember, if you ain't having fun, you're doing it wrong.